engine there, I don't know if you noticed it, with a fantail type tender, and that was stolen. And we never heard of that anymore. But the best part about it was that I had just rehashed it and put on a paper valve gear, and it had run and pulled like the mischief. Then somebody came in the window and took it. But I want to say this, it was attractive enough for all kinds of people to come and see it, to see it operate. Editors from magazines and so on that expected to find a live steamer was one that had all kinds of machinery and a bench with an engine on it. The idea of steam engines running trains around on a scenic railroad was something new entirely, and they wrote it up. So we got a tremendous lot of publicity. So all this kind of stuff was going on, and bringing more people to the basement. And each one, it seems, would want to ask the question, how can you get started on this? Until there were so many that two or three of us decided the thing to do was to form a club and put out this information on more or less of a mass production basis, because it was, I know it was wearing me out, telling them all how I built these things and so on, and how they could get started. So that is how the club, the live steamer, started from there. That was in about 1939 or late in 1938.
we're going to be screwed is what we all be saying. But the left seems to help. Gloves in there, right? That warmer's off.
Oh, yeah. What's it doing?
Yeah.
And that's okay. Shove them in.
That looks okay?
Yeah.
More blower, more fire if you have a cold. Less blower, less fire. When you run it, you can run it.
Thank you.
cover.
Website. One of those white signs has our website, ggls.org.